So good morning students, today we are going to discuss the new term in the thermodynamics, that is entropy. In the last class we discussed, in addition to the decreasing the energy criteria, there is some other factor which behind a spontaneous process, that is increasing the randomness is the criteria is useful to say a process is said to be a spontaneous or non-spontaneous. So during that spontaneous process, if the randomness is increased, so that randomness, the extent of randomness or disorderness in a system can be expressed by one thermodynamic property. That thermodynamic property we are called as entropy. This is generally represented with S. So it may be defined as, the property of a system which measures the degree of disorder or randomness of a system or in the system. That can be measured with the help of a thermodynamic property, that is called entropy. So like internal energy and enthalpy, it is also a state function. It depends upon initial state and final state of the system. Exact randomness of a system cannot be determined, so that only we can change in entropy can be calculated. So that's why during a process, change in entropy is equal to the entropy of a system final and entropy of system in initial state. That is delta S is equal to S final minus S initial. And similarly for a chemical reaction, also we can calculate the change in entropy. Delta S is equal to entropy of products minus entropy of reactants. For a chemical reaction, you write here reaction, reactants gives rise to products. Then change in entropy for a chemical reaction is equal to entropy of the products minus entropy of reactants. Here I write SP is equal to entropy of products and SR is equal to entropy of reactants. So the expression for entropy change may be get like this expression for entropy. So generally, let us take a system. This is a system is absorbed. You are adding certain amount of E to say Q. Then what is happen immediately? This system gain the energy. Then whatever the molecules are there, that molecules are move very fast. Molecules move fast. Molecules move fast is because of which one? This is because of the kinetic energy is increases. So moves fast means is clearly indicates disorderness. Disorderness increases. When the system is absorbing a certain amount of heat, the molecules are moving very fast because of their kinetic energy is increases. That is clearly indicates disorderness is increases. So that's why what we say from this one is more heat is absorbed, more heat absorbed, then more disorderness is observed. More disorderness observed. This is the one might be useful to express the expression for entropy. And let us take the another one is the system was there. One is at low temperature and another one is at high temperature. One system is at low temperature and the same systems, for example, high temperature. So for both the system, I can supply the same amount of energy Q and Q amount of energies I am supplying. Then where we are getting more disorderness? So the system which is at low temperature is more disordered by absorbing the Q amount of energy compared to the system already at high temperature. Because the wherever the system is at a high temperature, it is already achieving the maximum randomness. By supplying the certain amount of energy, the change in the randomness is very, very less. But whereas the system is at low temperature, when we are supplying the same amount of heat as we supplied at a high temperature, then here the more randomness is observed. And the change in the randomness is more in the system which is at low temperature as compared to high temperature. So from this one, the generally what we say that the entropy is inversely proportional to temperature. Entropy is inversely proportional to the temperature. Then from this one, so the delta S is related to Q and T for a reversible process. For a reversible process as follows. That is, we get an equation delta S is equal to Q reversible by T. This is the expression for the entropy. Now, the change in entropy during a process, how do you write here? The change in entropy during a process is defined as the amount of heat absorbed isothermally and reversibly divided by absolute temperature. Absolute temperature at which the heat is absorbed. The heat is absorbed. Like that we can define. So what are the units of entropy? So units of entropy. The units of entropy, so delta S is equal to Q reversible by T. That is Q is heat, we are expressing joule, temperature in Kelvin. Joule for Kelvin is the units for entropy. So now, here, a given process is said to be a spontaneity or non-spontaneous process. That is, we have to be expressed in terms of entropy change. So for example, let us take the two examples. Mixing of the two gases or the another example we discussed in the initially in the first lecture of this entropy, spreading a drop of ink in a beaker filled with water. So now in both these processes, no energy and matter exchanges. That means both are isolated systems. Does not exchange either energy or matter with the surroundings is called isolated system. But either in the mixing of the two gases by opening the valve or when we add a drop of ink to the water which is present in the beaker, in both the cases, so the randomness is increases. Because before the mixing of a two gases, the number of possible locations will be confined to their respective vessels. Once we are open the valve, the two gases are distributed in both the containers. That's why the number of possible locations of each gas molecule is increases. That is clearly indicates the randomness is increases. And that means when we are compared with the initial state, in the final state the randomness is more. That's why the change in randomness is always said to be positive. Similarly, before drop added to the water, the entropy of the system is very, very less. It is almost zero. But when we are added a drop of ink, immediately it will be distributed throughout the solution. So the randomness of that ink drop will be increases. So that's why the change in entropy, so this process is positive. For both the process, during this process, randomness increases. So from the initial state to the final state, that is clearly indicates the delta S value is said to be positive. Here, mixing of a two gases or spreading a drop of ink in a beaker filled with water, both the process are takes place spontaneously. During this process, the entropy of the system is increases. So that is the randomness is increases. So that the change in entropy is always said to be a process. That's why for a spontaneous process, what we said that delta S is equal to positive. So these are the two processes will be takes place in an isolated system. Here there is no exchange of energy and matter between the system and surroundings. Let us take the another two examples. So here cooling down of a cup of hot tea or Another example, reaction between NaOH and HCl. In these cases, exchange of energy and matter can be takes place. Whenever a cup of hot tea is cooled down, so it can be exchange energy with the surroundings, as well as this some water vapor is also will be evaporated, matter is also exchanges. During the reaction between NaOH and HCl also the heat energy is liberated, that is exchanges with the surroundings. That's why, so in these both the process, these are not an isolated system as we discussed in the early. So here this is takes place between the system and surroundings. When the energy is exchanged between the system and the surroundings during these two processes, we need to be consider entropy of a system. We need to be consider the change in entropy, as well as entropy of a surroundings also will be, we need to be consider. So when we measure the entropy of a system and entropy of the surroundings during the these two process, what they find out is the delta S is equal to positive. That means the entropy of the system is increases. So here I write one statement, delta S total is equal to delta S system plus delta S surroundings. We need to be taken into the consideration whenever a system is not said to be isolated system. After measuring the change in entropy of a system and the change in entropy of a surroundings, by adding these two, if you are getting the positive, that process is said to be a spontaneous process. If it is negative, that process is said to be a non-spontaneous process. But here cooling down a cup of hot tea or reaction between NaOH and HCl, so these two processes are takes place very spontaneously without doing any work on that one. So that's why in both the cases what we are observed, the increasing the randomness is observed. That is clearly indicates, so for a spontaneous process the delta S is equal to positive. So from this one, so we are concluded one statement here. In order to say a process is said to be a spontaneous process, the delta S must be, what is that? Positive. I write one statement here, for all spontaneous processes, so the total entropy change, is always positive. So this is led to the formation of second law of thermodynamics. What is second law of thermodynamics? Simply, it states that the entropy of the universe always increases in course of every spontaneous process. The entropy of the universe is always increases in course of every spontaneous process. So the limitation of the first law of thermodynamics, the law of conservation of energy, but it does not says about in which direction the process has to be proceeded. So now the second law of thermodynamics states that, so the process is always takes place in a direction naturally to whichever the side the randomness is increased to that side, so the process has to be takes place. So now here one more, I would like to give the one more important note, that is, So now the spontaneous process are always takes place in the direction of increasing the randomness. The randomness is increases continuously, but at a particular stage it is become constant. That where that randomness is does not changes, that where that position we say that equilibrium is achieved. At equilibrium, is there any change in entropy? No. The change in entropy is always become equal to zero. That's why the change in entropy at equilibrium is always equal to zero. That I write here statement is, in all the spontaneous processes, in all spontaneous processes, the entropy and randomness keep on increasing till ultimately an equilibrium is reached. An equilibrium is reached means here the entropy of the system is maximum at equilibrium. There is no further change in entropy means. So that is the entropy of the system is maximum at equilibrium. So entropy of the system is maximum at equilibrium means change in entropy at equilibrium, what is happened? Zero. That is delta S is equal to zero at equilibrium. This is the another important point. So now let us take one example, that is water molecule. You can apply the entropy criteria to decide the process is said to be a spontaneous or not in the case of conversion of water liquid to water solid. So now let us take first, I would like to the case one at 272 Kelvin temperature. That is 272 Kelvin means it is less than 0 degrees centigrade. So at this is, because it is an open system, the delta S total is equal to what we write here, entropy of the system plus entropy of surroundings. So liquid to solid, generally this value delta H is equal to negative. Based on that process we say that it is in a spontaneous process, delta H value. Based on that entropy criteria, now we have to be decide here delta H system value, because whenever the liquid is converted into solid, the entropy of the system is decreases. Okay, so that the entropy change in entropy is found to be 21.85, and your entropy of the surroundings is here it is released, so that entropy of the surroundings is increases, the change in entropy is become positive. So that here delta H is equal to plus 0.08 joule Kelvin inverse mole inverse. Here delta S value we are getting positive. So that the conversion of a liquid into solid, that freezes of water at 272 Kelvin temperature, it is spontaneous. Let us take at 274 Kelvin. At 274 Kelvin, so again you write the reaction, H2O liquid gives rise to H2O solid, then delta S total is equal to delta S system plus delta S surroundings. So now, whenever at 274 Kelvin temperature, the entropy of the system is minus 22.13. But the entropy of the surroundings is 22.05. So we get here minus 0.08. So joule, Kelvin inverse, mole inverse. The same process at 274 Kelvin, at 1 degree centigrade. So what is happened? It is non-spontaneous process. Non-spontaneous process. And same at the third case is at 273 Kelvin temperature. Then delta S total is equal to delta S system plus delta S surroundings. The delta S system is minus 21.99 plus the delta S surroundings is also 21.99. So now here it is become equal to 0. That means at 273 Kelvin temperature it is in equilibrium stage. The change in entropy is become 0. That is clearly indicates it is in equilibrium stage. So that means it is neither melting nor freezing. Here, neither melting nor freezing takes place. So, here like that, at different temperatures, so the entropy of the universe is different. In the case of water molecule, at 272, that process is feasible. But by rising the temperature to 274 Kelvin, that is non-spontaneous, at 273 Kelvin, there is no change in entropy, so that the total entropy change is equal to 0, that is at an equilibrium. Like that, we can decide it based on that criteria of entropy. If delta S is equal to positive, then the system undergo spontaneous process. If delta S is equal to negative, that is a non-spontaneous process, and if delta S is equal to 0, that is at equilibrium. So finally, we concluded the certain important properties regarding this entropy. So this entropy is an extensive property which is depends upon the amount of a substance present in the system, and entropy is a state function. It is depends upon initial state and final state of the system, and your change in entropy is dependent of a path. Okay, it is depends upon initial and final state, and what path we are reaching the final state is never mind. And the total entropy change of a system is always equal to entropy of the system plus as well as entropy of the surroundings. When we add these two entropies, change in entropy of system and surroundings, we get delta S total, that is we called entropy of the universe. If the entropy of the universe is greater than 0, that process is said to be spontaneous. And if it is less than 0, non-spontaneous. If it is equal to 0, at equilibrium. For an irreversible process, the entropy of the universe is always greater than 0. That means irreversible process means the process will be takes place in only one direction. In whichever the direction, so takes place, obviously that is naturally takes place. That's why all irreversible processes are generally said to be a spontaneous process. In those cases, the entropy of the system is always positive. So this is about the entropy and change in entropy. From this one, we are concluded the second law of thermodynamics, that is the entropy of the universe is always increases in the course of every spontaneous change. That is called second law of thermodynamics.